Hey everyone, Jason here, digital marketing consultant, and in this Canva tutorial, you're going to learn the fastest way to put together a clickable and editable PDF using Canva. So timestamp table of contents in the description, along with some deeper dive videos if you want to explore how to really create your own designs in Canva. Here, we're just going to focus on how you can quickly put together a great looking PDF that can be edited and is also clickable to your website or any other social links that you want. So with that, let's go ahead and jump right in. The fastest way to do it is, of course, looking for one of Canva's templates. All you have to do once you've logged into your Canva account is go over to the left-hand side and click on templates. And there are a lot of templates in here, as you can see. There are just a ton of different templates, a ton of different types. You can also use the search bar at the top. But the fastest way to put together a PDF really is to just scroll through these templates, choose one that you think is close enough to what you want to do. Remember, just 80-20, get it done. Done is better than perfect, and choose a template. In this particular example, I'm going to be using something from one of our courses and then actually creating a checklist from scratch so you can see how you can add some edit functionality for whoever's using the PDF once they've downloaded it and they don't have to have access to Canva in order to do that, and then also how you can create clickable links inside of your PDF. So with that, let's go ahead and just choose one of our checklist templates right here. After scrolling through to save us some time, I've just gone with this really basic checklist. You can always get more advanced later. Now, when it comes to designing your PDF, actually one of the fastest ways is good old-fashioned pen and paper, so that's what I typically do, and then I start modifying the template that I'm looking at. It also helps with making sure that I know that I get all the information I need onto my template. So in this particular instance, to save us some time, I've gone ahead and quickly modified this template with the text that I actually want. So before we export it and use another tool to allow our users to actually edit this, let's go ahead and change up some of the design elements so it better matches our brand. Now, if you're using a paid account, you might have this brand option here where you can have presets. So I'll just try a couple of my presets here, and probably none of them are gonna work because these are all for other things. And of course not. Okay, cool. So let's go ahead and actually manually do this. So to change the style or color of your text, all you have to do is click on it. You'll have all of the normal options that you'd expect with something like this. So we're gonna go ahead and just change up the colors real quick, and then we'll be good to go. And to spruce up our PDF a little bit, let's go ahead and use an icon. This is about Google Analytics. So I'm just going to search for analytics here on the left-hand side and see if there are any free things that I can use for this that would make sense. This rocket kind of looks cool, so I'll go ahead and use this rocket here. I could have just as easily gone to Google and searched for their own analytics logo, but I really like the way this rocket looks. So I'm gonna go ahead and click and drag and then center it. Of course, we're actually going to change the transparency so we can still read things. So I can click up here on transparency and bring the transparency down a little bit and probably down a little more. And for time purposes, I'm just going to call it good. Obviously, there's a little more we'd want to do to make sure that it's easy, much easier to read. Now, when it comes to creating clickable links inside of your PDF, Canva, of course, has you covered, so all we need to do is add some text, but I like making it really clear that it's a button because most people who are looking at a PDF don't know that they should be clicking it. So we'll come over here to shapes, and I'll go ahead and click on this square element, and we're going to bring it to the front. Now we'll shrink it down a little bit, and the reason that you want to do this is you want to make it very clear that they should be clicking on the link because it's not going to be intuitive for people. So we'll go ahead and add some text here and we'll say click here and give them a reason to click. We'll say free analytics training. We see it's a little too big, so we'll come up here and let's bring it down to 24 and then we will click and drag it right on top of our little box element. Center that right there. We'll probably change the text color here so it's a little easier to read. We'll go white. but actually it kind of blends in a little too much. So I'm actually going to go with this dark color, and then I will change the actual box to a different lighter color so it's much easier to read and stands out a little more. There we go. So click here, free analytics training, and then all we need to do is click on select the text, and then also select your background box. So you might have to do this. So we're selecting both, and now we can group them together. And now we can click on link up here and add in our website URL. So as soon as we add in a URL here, now when we export it into whatever, as long as, not whatever format, as long as we export it as a PDF, then this link will be clickable. And we'll go ahead and click on apply. And now whoever downloads this PDF will clearly know that they can click here and it will actually take them to our website. So let's go ahead and download this. So we can do PDF print or PDF standard. And if you have a really long PDF, then go ahead and do standard just because it's going to be easier for people to download. Here it's just one page. So we'll go ahead and just do it for print. Obviously, if you download it in any other format, the link is not going to work and that'll just be a different tutorial because it's not a PDF, right? So we'll go ahead and select just our second page here because our first page still looks like the template, and we'll go ahead and click on download. So I'll show you how to take this and actually make it clickable and editable in another, well, it's already clickable, so I'll show you how you can create it so your users can actually edit it. So we're done publishing, and then I'll actually show you how to create a fill in the blank, and this is actually from one of our paid trainings, and I'll show you how we took this PDF and made it easy for our students to essentially just fill in the blanks right within the PDF. So let's go over to pdfescape.com. This is a free tool, and all we have to do is click and drag our design right in here. So I'm going to look at my other screen here and click and drag the file that we just created. And once our PDF has loaded up, all we need to do is come up here to the top left-hand side, click on form field. We'll have different options here, and we'll go ahead and select checkbox. In the next example, I'll go through creating a text field. And once we've selected that, we can click and drag just around the border that we have here for our check mark. And now we have a check mark. So all we have to do here is go ahead and, whoops, there we go. There's an extra one. We can click on it and then we can right click and duplicate. And then we can go ahead and move these over to every single place that we want a check mark. Now, of course, this is going to be a little tedious, right? So I'm going to skip ahead to where I have all of our check marks done. And just like that, we have all of our check mark boxes here. So when we export this, whoever's using it will be able to check and uncheck these boxes. Now, of course, these are all blank, so we should give them some area to actually write in what their UTM parameters are going to be. So this time we're going to go ahead and select text, and then select, and we'll click and drag. So you'll notice that this is a little harder, right? Because we didn't, inside of Canva, make sure that everything was lined up correctly. So I definitely recommend, if you're going to have text boxes like this, that you create everything inside of Canva, so that way you can easily click and drag in using Canva, because it's going to be a lot easier to essentially have things line up. So I'll just click and drag here and speed ahead again for time purposes.
1 eternity later.
And now we have all of our text boxes. Before we save and download, you'll notice if I mouse over our button, the link is still there, although you can create links, some additional links if you want, using the link function in PDF Escape. So let's go ahead, save and download here. And now when I open up our PDF, you'll see that the link is still here. This will take us to our website, and I can type in whatever I want here, and I can check and uncheck these boxes. And so that's all there is to it, to using Canva and PDF Escape to create these really, really simple but good looking PDFs that your customers or clients can actually use. So let's go ahead and go back over to PDF Escape, and I'll just go through one more quick example here. This is going to be for our course, so I'll click and drag the PDF in here. It'll take just a couple of seconds to upload. I'll go a lot faster through this example, and we'll click on page number 2 here. We'll go to form field, go to text, text paragraph, select, and then click and drag. Yeah, right around there. We're good to go. So we'll go ahead and download this one again so you can see exactly how it works. And now that it's done, we can open it up. We'll go to page number 3 here, and you'll see that I can click and start typing in as much as I need to. And if we go down to the other pages, you'll see that there's no way to click in them because we didn't set that up. And so with that, you're good to go with Canva and PDF Escape to create your editable PDFs. If you have any questions, go ahead and drop them in the comment section below. I do read and reply to every single one. And if you want more tutorials on how to use Canva to create your worksheets, your ebooks, or even your Instagram posts, make sure you check out the Canva creation guide and playlist in the description for everything designing with Canva. So thank you so much for watching. Sincerely hope you got some value out of this video. Hit that like button, subscribe for more videos just like this one, and until the next, keep building the business you love.